Welcome everyone to a new Legacy video. Today we're playing Hogaak. We did record with this deck for Legacy a couple of weeks ago when the deck was still legal in Modern. I tried to make like the meme of just not changing the card. Today instead we're trying to play an actual competitive deck. This deck 5-0'd multiple times on Legacy and we are playing it in some new cards. So Hogaak, it's a 7 mana 8/8, but you can't kept up your lands. You can't spend mana to cast this. You have to either convoke or delve, and this has a trample. You can play it from graveyard as well, so it does the combo with Altar of Dementia, Bridge from Below, Hogaak. You can just mirror your opponent out. You just need one altar in play, one or two bridge in the graveyard, and one or two Hogaak in play. So either two bridges and one Hogaak or one bridge and two Hogaak just goes infinite. Just mirrors your whole deck and then their old deck. And then you just win because they don't have cards in the deck. Unless they have Emrakul, at which point you can just play zombies and pass the turn. 20 lands, one more than what we see in Modern, because in this format exists Wasteland. You can even see playing more Swamps. Playing Undiscovered Paradise, which is a land that as for any color, but you have to return it in your untap step, which is good with Bloodgust, because you can just, have your land drop again, or good with Faithless Looting in the late game, to just discard extra lands. The rest of the deck is basically Modern. We have Cabal Therapy, which is a... Wow, this is weird. What's this? Only that one is this way? Or whatever. Cabal Therapy, which is very good in this deck because you have a lot of fodder, and with Bridging the Graveyard, you can just make multiple zombies or for free by just replaying the Grave Crawlers. You can even target yourself and just discard Bridge. And then we have Entomb, which is, I think, a main deck only card. It is good to just go off with Bridge by putting the Bridge in the graveyard, but I think Possessor we're just always gonna cut the Entomb. It kind of feels very weak to me. This deck is not playing Neonate and Vengevine. This whole, the whole package that this deck basically, you cut 4 Neonate, 4 Vengevine, you put Cabal Therapy and Entomb. And I can see, if you play the Vengevine, you can't really not play Neonate, and we need to have space for Cabal Therapy. Entomb at the end of the day is pretty solid in the game 1 to just let you go off every time with Bridge as soon as possible. So yeah, 20 lands and then a pretty straightforward main deck. In the side we have Talia for the combo decks, and 4 Wear Tear for the Leyline decks, 1 Shining Guns for the Chalice of the Void decks, and then some Thoughtseize, Surgical, and Coffin Purge. They used to play Goblin Bombardment, but it ended up being cut, so yeah, just Surgical for the Reanimator deck, and then Thoughtseize, Talia for the combo deck, because this is not the fastest of the combo decks. This doesn't really win on turn 3 unless you have Altar in hand, unless it's... It's very rare to win on turn 3, especially without Vengevine, so it's kind of a like engine value deck, basically like Dredge, but you can beat Surgical rather easily with this deck. Rest in Peace on Leyline will be much harder. So yeah, let's see how this deck performs and what do we do. And remember that this is ChannelFireball.com and this is Andrea Mengucci, and if you like to... like what you see, you like the Legacy videos, remember that you can buy cards from Channel Fireball by using the link that's in the description. And that link will basically just, nothing will change, you'll get already directed to Channel Fireball, but I'll get, some support from you. So yeah, see you later. Okay, this is not the best of the hands, but I think this is just unkeepable. We're very close to play a turn 2 Hogaak. We either miss... No, actually, yeah, I just can't keep this hand. It's too many bad cards. Alright, let's keep this instead. I'm gonna ship to the bottom of Bridge, I think. Everything else I can cast, and I kinda need the 2 lands, so yeah. If I had the looting, maybe I would've kept that Bridge, I don't know. Tropical Preordain. There's a lot of Delver deck. And I don't think this deck is bad against Delver. I think this deck might just be bad against just Graveyard 8 and some faster combo decks. Alright, I'm gonna go Swamp, Stitcher Supplier. This is definitely the first thing to attempt to resolve, because then you can just put into Graveyard like Bloodgast or... Alright, I get a Cabal Therapy. But I don't think I want to do it, so I'm just gonna pass the turn here. Next turn, I can go something like Carrium? I don't know. Let's see what we do. Alright, more Preordain. I was playing 2 Preordain in my Delver of Random 6, so this can still be in that range. Could it also be Abnaus and Tendrils, but that deck, I'm not sure if they play Tropical main deck. Maybe just one sideboard, green land for the sideboard hate. My thoughts is me. Okay. Yeah, this could be Abnaus and Tendrils. Discard Carrion Feeder, of course. And what do we draw? Entomb. Interesting. Had I had the Carrion Feeder in my hand. So what happens here? I could Cabal Therapy myself to mill the Stitcher Supplier and Discard Bridge. But he's not the worst. So Entomb, what can he do in this deck? Put in a graveyard Hogaak, but we don't have two creatures to tap them for it. I can put in a graveyard Gravecrawler, and then just cast it from the graveyard, and then just Cabal Therapy them with the Gravecrawler. Or me Cabal Therapy myself with the Gravecrawler. I don't think that's good though. I kind of like to just Cabal Therapy them with Stitcher's Web. I am attacking. This deck does not play Vengevine. Alright, so we'll attack first, and then like Cabal Therapy myself, I think. Yes, I Cabal Therapy myself and then Breach from below. Alright, mill the bridge. I milled the bridge. Now I'm gonna cast a Bloodgast with a Scrubland, I think, because Puna could still be playing a Wasteland deck. I'll play Bloodgast and pass the turn. Yeah, this turn was rough. Like, with Stitcher Supplier is always weird. You don't really know what to do exactly, you know, because if you mill well or if you mill bad, it really depends on that. If I draw a creature now, I can Entomb for Hogaak and play Hogaak. Yeah, best draw is obviously Carrion Feeder or Altar. Altar also is an amazing draw. Altar probably just wins. Alright, opponents played Abnausium, I told you. But I still didn't feel like just Cabal Therapy damn and naming Inferno Tutor in the dark. That could be like, I don't know, a version with Burning Wish. And I think that discarding Bridge gives me the out of just winning the game if I get a Altar next turn as well, so I could just not have the Inferno Tutor. So they go Dark Petition here. They have 6 mana floating with the Lensai Diamond sack. I think though they did not crack the Lensai Diamond. That's weird. Maybe the Cardinal is very good. So I get 3 black sources here. They might just take another Lensai Diamond. They have Inferno Tutor in hand. That's also a possibility. Alright, they got 3 black. And yeah, I mean, okay, as I said, this is a bad match for this deck. Because our clock is not very good. Like, it's like we're playing Dredge, okay, but with less explosive, which is, it's not exciting as you put it like that way, but we're more resilient to Cyborg Hate. We're more resilient to, like, Surgical Extraction. That's why I think this deck is actually better than Dredge at this point. But, I mean, we'll see. Okay, they just tutored and passed. Maybe they just made a mistake with the Lensai Diamond there. Alright, drawing Bloodgust means that I can go for Hogaak. The question is, do I want to go for Hogaak? Or I'd rather go for Cabal Therapy. If I go for Cabal Therapy, they must have taken the Infernal Tutor, right? So I'm gonna go for Cabal Therapy here. Yeah, opponent, I don't get to hold priority thing. It doesn't work sometimes. Yeah. Sometimes it doesn't work. Sorry, I'm gonna say. Alright, so I'm gonna play attack, play all my cards, and put into Cabal Therapy in the graveyard. And to remember, it's any card, not just a creature like you would think most of the times. So yeah, normally, in a normal game, I would have Entombed Hogaak, played Bloodgast, top 2 black sources in Exile 5, and just played Hogaak. But I think in a situation like this, we need to, you know, name Infernal Tutor. So yeah, I don't know what's going on right now. I mean, opponent, of course, pretty frustrated. They probably had the win. I don't know, honestly. They would have gone for a thousand tendrils. It's not the win. It's like they still need to hit. Okay, I mean, yeah, they were very likely to win. Here, I am going to go for Infernal Tutor. They're probably just frustrated, and hopefully they don't just leave and just leave us like this. It is sometimes bad to just play Magic Online. I don't know. Maybe you need to hold priority before casting it. It's always a thing with Lands and Diamond. If you remember one of my Legacy videos prior to this, I did try also this deck and got screwed by Lands and Diamond. I don't know if this is their first time playing the deck or what. It could be. I mean, the opponent's called the Storm, so they kind of are a Storm Master, probably. Alright. Okay, so let's go in Tomb. Let's put a Cabal Therapy in the graveyard. And let's target our opponent, naming Infernal Tutor. Making two zombies. Passing flames they got. Okay. Now I'll play a land. And then I'll play a Blood Gust. And then it's my opponent turn with a passing flames in their hand. So I had to find an Hogaak, I would have won next turn, probably. Actually, not even. Because I would have just dealt 14. No, sorry, 12. So yeah, still wouldn't have been lethal. But this way, I prevented in case my opponent went for an Infernal Tutor. Positive Flames also makes sense, but yeah. So they can now have 7 mana to their pool. They now have 7 mana to their pool. Positive Flames costs 4. Then they have 3 mana. Then they can go Dark Ritual, Dark Petition. They needed a ritual to go for a now, so they could go for tokens, but I don't even think the tokens got them out of here. Remember, so if a token trades with a Bloodgast, the ritual below dies, but what happens is that you still get the token. So if you get 4 tokens and the Bloodgast dies, and the ritual below gets exiled, but I do get 4 tokens if I click them in the right order. In paper, you do get tokens. Online, you have to click them in the right order. Alright, so they go for Dark Ritual. And they have 4 mana in their pool, so they have to just play a cantrip and hope to find a spell. That's weird, the sequencing that they did. They should have probably just played the cantrip. Start with a cantrip. They don't shuffle in the final lands that diamond. Alright, I guess they're alright. Still going for the Ponder here. Going bottom. So they could still fizzle for the way they sequence the cards, I think. My Ponder not shuffle, unfortunately, so yeah, this must be another ritual. I assume a Cabal Ritual. Cabal Ritual wins them the game, because they can go Cabal Ritual, and then just play cards, and then Dark Petition Tendrils. But again, they would probably won this game without the misclick, so... Alright, they go Preordain. They go top and bottom. Top, bottom. Petal. Preordain again. Mm-hmm. They go bottom. I don't know, there's a chance maybe. Maybe there's a chance. So if they cast the Cabal Ritual, they go to 6 mana, which is enough for the Dark Petition to be lethal. So Cabal Ritual wins the game, Lands of Diamond wins the game. Dark Ritual does not win the game. Dark Ritual, wow, I concede. This is a weird game. They did not shuffle and then they... Alright, opponent probably just frustrated by how the game went to end, honestly. Game 1, how game, misclick went. Alright, so we won Thalia and Thoughtseize. I don't think I want Surgical. I don't think I want Coffin Purge. I think Coffin Purge is just for Reanimator. And you keep Entomb in, instead in this matchup I'm gonna cut Entomb entirely. I know that I can put in Graveyard Cabal Therapy, but I think I just want to... only have like this kind of interaction, then just be a combo deck. Yeah, I just want to be a combo deck here, so I'm not gonna trim too much. When I was playing Hogaak in Modern, I was usually cutting like one Grave Crawler, one Bloodgast where it affects lots. I could usually were board. I was boarding out to Neonate and Vengevine. Those two cards are now gone. I did play this deck in Modern a fair bit. I'm playing against the deck without land disruptions. I think I'm gonna just cut the land in this matchup. That seems strange, but I think it's fine. Because opponent is not wastelanding guys, or even on the draw. And this deck used to play 19 lands, so I think this is fine. Yeah, I'm gonna go like this. Alright, this then does not have any interaction, but I do have two Faithless Looting, so I can find my Thalia along the way. So I'm gonna keep it. Also it has like Faithless Looting into Bloodgas Bridge. It's a pretty good start. But again, I might just not be able to cast Thalia because I die on turn 2. It's legacy, guys. You know, combo decks kills fast. You need Force of Negation. You need Daze. You need Wasteland. This is why the deck, the format is self-correct. Or I guess it's sorry. This is why the format is fair. Because the unfair deck have the grid answers to them. Alright, draw Altar. Opponent does not shuffle. I draw an Altar. It's good. I'm gonna go Badland Faithless Looting. Keeping this fetch on in case my opponent has a Surgical for the Blob Guest. Alright, drawing 2 lands obviously is awful, but not much I can do about it. And let's see what happens here. Next time I'm gonna start the turn with Faithless Looting, looking for Thoughtseize. Okay, so they fetch first. Mm-hmm. Just looking for Thoughtseize. Obviously Thalia can't play. They go top bottom with the Ponder, the Preordain, and the Ponder. Okay, yeah. If I had Thalia here, I think I would have just won the game. I don't know. Alright, come on, let's draw Thalia here. Thalia, boom. Thalia, please. Thalia. Beam. Bloodgust. Alright. Let's get Cabal Therapy at least. Nothing? Oh, well, nothing is very bad. Nothing is very, very, very bad. Alright, so let's discard this too. Let's play a fetch land. This one get back, and if they have Surgical, I can steal a fetching response. So Surgical does not work on the Bloodgust with fetch land. That's why if you have Surgical, you have to main phase it. And I'm gonna get another Badlands, but I don't have the idea that I might have a Thalia in my deck. If they win this game, at least game 3, maybe they don't have any sideboard slot for it. And then just turn 2 Thalia and win. Because you might be like, yeah, why you have Thalia? You have Faithless Looting, Altar of Dementia. Sure, sure, we have some few spells we want to cast, actually only these two, and Cabal Therapy and Thoughtseize, but this deck has a lot of creatures, can easily play without casting spell. Whereas their deck needs to cast a lot of spell. Wow, they just cast all the cantrips in the world. So we do have more shots at finding what we want to find here. Alright, let's see. End of turn, I could sacrifice these things to Carrion Feeder, and it's actually a thing that you have to do, because you deal 2 more damage this way. Because what happens is, I still be on 2 power, I'm still on 2 power, but I put 2 more power on the Carrion Feeder. So, like, the Bloodgust and the Zombies are equal power, but now I have 2 more power here. And this turn, we can't even... Actually, maybe I shouldn't have done it, because now... I shouldn't have done it, maybe, guys. I made a mistake. I was all about just flashbacking this to find Cabal Therapy. But instead, what I needed to find was just to try to win with Altar of Dementia. So yeah, that was a mistake. I did give up milling 2 cards. But that's okay, I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna try to win this game. So I'll play Altar of Dementia here. I'll mill 3. I'll mill 3 cards by sacrificing this Carrion Feeder. Mill myself, of course. Now I can play a fetch land. Get 2 Bloodgust in my deck, then mill 4, and then I get 4 tokens, then I can mill myself, and as long as we find Hogaak, we win. And Altar of Dementia is just, it's huge, should be a win regardless. For some reason I was mono, all in on finding Cabal Therapy. This way I can also just find Cabal Therapy as well. Alright, we did not find an Hogaak, but that's okay, I'm gonna fetch, get a Scrubland, return the Bloodgust, then mill again. I think we should have the game right now. It's very unlikely that we don't find Hogaak, and once we find it, it's game over. There it is. Whatever you exile is not relevant. Unless you exile Bridge from below. No, yeah, this game's over. Gonna mill our opponent deck. I'm gonna also mill fork about therapy just in case we fizzle. Alright. And also, it's not relevant right now, but you should do this play every time. You go alt priority, so click control, and then click on the Hogaak, and then pay 2, eat things from the graveyard, and then when the Hogaak is on the stack, you mill yourself. So this way, you get one less tap. Which, again, is not relevant right now, but some games you might be tight, and you should do that. This game is obviously not one of them, but still, just to get the habit. So you're always used to it. So I click control, build it on the stack, and I mill them this time, because it doesn't really matter. So yeah, we'll mill them 8, and then we mill them 8. Let's play this from the graveyard. Let's play Hogaak. Let's mill them 8. The opponent doesn't want to consider, they want to see how does this game win, this deck win. We'll mill them 2. Alright, and then we win the match because we mill them entirely, and then we also just cover therapy dam just to make sure, you know, they can't win an upkeep, I don't know. And yeah, that's the win. It was a turn 3 kill, and it was all thanks to the altar. If it wasn't for the altar, we wouldn't have won on turn 3. We would have just, you know, just hoped to find a cyber card, but we are also combo deck, so we got the turn 3 kill. Alright, that's a pretty good game 2 showing. Game 1 wasn't that good, but yeah, game 2 was. So let's be back for round number 2. Round number 2, we're on the draw again. This end looks like it has all the pieces. It could be very, very fair, though. We need Faithless Loading for this end to work. I think I'm gonna keep this hand. It just has both of the key card, Hogaak and Bridge. I'm not gonna ship it. Alright, but playing as basic island, go. Yeah, we live in a stifle world these days. So it makes sense that our opponent just fetched main phase. I'm gonna get Swamp. I'm gonna get Battling, so many lands here. And I'll play a Gravecrawler. So attacks for 2. You wanna play Badland because if you draw Faithless Looting into a Bloodghast, you wanna be able to reanimate in the same turn. Alright, so it looks like you're playing as either Miracles or a combo deck. Ooh, Altar. Altar is the key against Miracles. I'm gonna just lower roll it. I don't want it to get counterspell. I'd rather them to counterspell my Carrion Feeder. I'm gonna play Carrion Feeder, fetch land, pass the turn. Fetch land, pass the turn. Alright, resolved. I could sacrifice this to then put a Gravecrawler from the graveyard, but it's just risky. Because if you sacrifice the Gravecrawler to the Carrion Feeder and they plow the Carrion Feeder, you just don't have anything left. So if our opponent was tapped out, I could have made the play of sacrificing the Gravecrawler to the Carrion Feeder, put the counter, and then play Carrion Feeder from the graveyard. But since our opponent's mana up, I don't feel comfortable in doing it. Same thing's why I didn't play Altar of Dementia this turn, which of course was the, you know, best card to resolve against his Miracles deck. Yeah, gone just probably just fetch end of turn. Having less lands in my deck. Sure, I have a Faithless Loading and such, but actually, yeah, it's I don't know. Let's see. So probably gonna get plowed, Carrion Feeder. I'm gonna sacrifice itself, or I have sixth, so no sacrifice itself. I think a Carrion Feeder into graveyard was very important here because I have a Hogaak, so I shouldn't have F6 there, but I did. Alright, it's no covered planes, so I don't know why, but it doesn't really matter, honestly. It should be just a free roll, just to have snow covered in your deck. Usually, the only reason why you're not playing snow covered lands in Magic these days is because you want to show your sweet beta dual land. Sorry, beta basic lands. That's at least my explanation of why I'm playing basics over snow covered lands. Because snow covered lands, you can't really. I mean, you could play foils, snow covered, but they're not very pretty. I mean, this is not. It's not a very pretty land. Sorry. For the. Okay, so they pass the turn here. They don't have at least a counterspell up. Ooh, Faithless Looting. That is the card that they need to counter. I think I'm gonna play a land. I'm gonna play a land first. It's very likely that they play a spell piercing their deck, so I'm gonna play a Faithless Looting first. You know, obviously it's awkward to just play Faithless Looting in a deck with land before Faithless Looting in a deck with. Alright, I go for spell piercing. Fucked. And I'm gonna just pay two because I really need to discard some cards here. I just wanna get three bad lands. I actually want Swamp on get. Maybe to go back to basics. Alright, so let's pay two. On the. Yes. Alright. I'll discard Bridge for sure and probably Hogaak. I don't think. I mean, we're main deck, so the Hogaak shouldn't be. This is not modern. They don't have a. They don't have what's called surgical main deck. All right, we did draw two. I mean, altar is fine, but I think this matchup is that good. Game one that I can just afford just not doing anything. It's very similar to modern. They may have mentor, which puts up the clock fast, but they don't have surgical, so you're just free eventually to just win thanks to altar. If altar resolves, which again they have spell priest in the graveyard, so I'm definitely gonna play around the snapcast range unless they go tap out before to play Jason Mask Altar. Oh, they did that back to basics. All right, we have two swamps in our deck, so let's take them. Let's play altar. We don't have another spell pierce. And now, our four speech brainstorm. Okay. Next turn, I'll play the altar and. This one should play around back to basics pretty well, right? Don't untap during their untap land. During your next untap step, you return it. Yeah, this one plays around back to basics very well. Alright, so next turn, I can go. I should probably win the game next turn. Because I can go Altar of the Mansion, sacrifice the Grave Crawler, mill to get a zombie, replay from the graveyard. And then I can play Hogaak and then just go off from there. So yeah, let's play the altar. And then just win. Yeah, I'm not gonna play land because I can mill a Bloodghast here. Play Hogaak. I'll mill myself. I mean, I could miss and pass the turn, but no, actually, I can't miss, really. I mean, I could still miss. It's unlikely, but I can still miss. Okay, I can't miss anymore. Game's over. I'll mill, get two zombies, and now I have enough tools to win the game. Two bridge and one Hogaak, it's enough. But even two Hogaak and one bridge is enough. So once you have one and one, it's very unlikely in the top 10 cards to not win. So yeah, despite our opponent did answer a lot, we still had the kill. Like, Altar is just unbeatable against the blue-white controls. Like, you just find a win anytime you have Altar. It's very, very resilient. As I said, it's very similar to Dredge. I mean, very hard to kill Dredge as well, game one. Okay, so now, what do they have? They usually don't play Rest in Peace. I could even see myself just not sideboarding anything. I could board in Coffin Purge. This is a way to play around surgical. Just have this laying in your graveyard. You can just target and exile your bridge so that there's surgical fizzle. So I can see having like one Coffin Purge for like one and two, but that's it. Yeah, I mean, I could also cut a land again. In this matchup, lands are not really worth it. Any Entomb is fine. I don't think having any of these makes sense. I'm not a fan of Thoughtseize. If they have Surgical, it's fine. I mean, I also have Cabal Therapy for that. I think I'll Coffee Purge for Scrubble and makes sense. Let's go with this. While in Modern, you have Rest in Peace in Blue-White. You don't really play Rest in Peace in Legacy, because Snapcaster is still one of the most important tools, and also there's not that many slow graveyard decks. And in Modern, I used to play four Cryptbreaker to win this matchup post-sideboard. Here I don't have them, but gotta keep this very slow hand. I still think it's reasonable. Sigil Supply is one of your best card in this deck. Gonna get kicks off with a Blasting Mar so that I could turn two Hogaak thanks to the two fetch lands. Also, just reducing lands in your deck, it's always relevant. What did they do with Ponder? They shuffled. Interesting. So kick things off with a Stitcher Supplier. Looking for Hogaak. I don't find it. I find a bridge. I can put Hogaak in my graveyard though. So next turn I could go for the Hogaak. So what do you wanna do here? This is strange though. Let's see what I draw. I draw Carrion Feeder, interesting. Okay, now all right, let's do this. Let's do this. Let's play Carrion Feeder. Let's play Fetchland and Swain Tomb. If they plow, the Stitcher Supplier can destroy capacity to Carrion Feeder. Right, play this immediately. Okay, that's fine. Okay, so now I can't cast Hogaak this turn at any point. So I'd rather just play a Gravecrawler and pass the turn. I can sacrifice a Gravecrawler to the Carrion Feeder. If I want to, but it's not guaranteed that I want to. Because my opponent could just have Surgical for my bridge, so I don't think I want to make this play. If it was game one, I would have definitely done it. Because you don't lose anything. But since they could have a. Alright, is this a back to basics? If it is, it's still not a big deal. I mean, no, it can be. I don't think back to basics is a threat in this matchup. They should probably not have it. We have two and mostly let's play three swamps. So what do we do? Just Narset would be probably a dream. Monster Mentor. Okay. All right. I'm not sacrificing it. As I said, the reason why is Surgical Extraction. All right. Another Entomb would be interesting. So let's go for Entomb. Put in Hogaak in the graveyard. I should have probably just fetched first. Now, in order to cast Hogaak, I need to exile my bridge, which sucks. Yeah, so I made a mistake. I should have fetched first and then played Entomb for Hogaak. That's okay though. I'll be fine with that. Actually, no, it's fine. Yeah, I'm gonna exile my bridge. Too sad, but that's life when you make a mistake. All right. So, what else do I want to do here? I could entomb for. No, I mean I could entomb for a blood gas, but is it really worth it? Maybe. You know what? I'm just sacrificing Gravecrawler to the Carrion Feeder and just replaying it from the graveyard. I could do it again, but I'd rather just pass the turn, leaving Entomb up in case my opponent plows the Hogaak. I can Entomb for a bridge, and then just sacrificing the bridge to the Carrion Feeder. Council Judgment. This is awkward because now, I mean, it is awkward right now because if I think I'm going to go for the Entomb for bridge. I mean, imagine just having a bridge in the graveyard. How cool would it be? So I'm just gonna go Entomb. Imagine how cool it would have been to have a bridge in the graveyard instead of the marsh flats. Yeah, last turn I just started off with the marsh flats crack and then Entomb for the Hogaak. So I'd opponent never had priority to surgical anything. So let's see if they have a Force of Will in hand. And this turn, if this resolves, I'm going to sacrifice my whole board. Sacrifice my whole board to get three tokens. And they have to... Made on control, alright. So they don't have to sacrifice to target a Royal Mentor. I mean, they could target a token, but that's fine. I still have two tokens to replay Hogaak from the graveyard. Alright, so let's vote for a zombie. The basketball therapy. Play Grave Crawler from the bin. I definitely don't have Surgical in hand. They must have Force of Will, in my opinion, because they thought so long. Every single play that they made, so I'm gonna Cabal Therapy them. They can't have Surgical. They would have. They had plenty of windows to play Surgical. So I'm not playing around Surgical, I'm playing around Force here. Alright, I play Force. Pitching Jace to my Sculptor. Okay. I could still play Force. I could play the Flashback of Cabal Therapy for free. Because I just sacrifice this Carrion Feeder and just play it from the graveyard. And I think I'll do it. Because I just get a zombie for free. So I'm doing it. I think I'm naming another Force of Will. I don't know what to name. And maybe just Brainstorm should be. But them forcing my... It doesn't make sense, right? Unless they have another Force of Will. It doesn't make sense to force my... To force my Cabal Therapy, so they must have another one. That's Jace. Okay. Counterbalance and Jace. Not the two best cards. Alright, I think I'm gonna just crack this fetch land now. Just dump that away to play my Hogaak. I'll top all the zombies because I need all these cards in the bin. Because my opponent can just bounce Hogaak next turn. And remember, you can't tap lands to play Hogaak, so this mana can't be tapped. Alright, and then I'll pass. So you have Counterbalance Jace. I do have an 8 Trample. I have a Stopping Trial Step. It is Terminus of... Alright. So I lose my board. Yep. Alright, so we are even, but have a counterbalance in play. Blind, but I also have a Jace Demise Sculpture. Best draws probably Fateless Looting. It makes sense to force the Cabal Therapy. Because I would have named Force, and then I would have just named Jace with a flashback. So the opponent just obviously made a good play there. Covered Paradise. I'll keep this in my hand because if I draw Fateless Loading, I want to have two bad cards to discard. I did board out a land in this game. Alright, I found a land so they can play Jace. I'm not giving up though because I could still draw something cool and just go off. Remember, we're a combo deck, so they probably just have Brainstorm and put a one drop in the top. We did try our best in this game, fighting a bunch of different things. Alright, Altar is good. Oh wow, I have a counterbalance on top. Alright, after this, I'm gonna concede. I think they deserve it. Alright, I don't think I want to change anything. I still think that Totsis is not good. You want to have like all the combo pieces and no Thoughtseize. So just having Coughing Purge, because if I mill it randomly with the Stitcher Supplier, it's a cool thing. Or if I have it in my hand, I can just discard it. And then it just sits in the graveyard for surgical purposes. And I just board out a land, which I think I still stand by my death choice. I still stand by that choice. Let's go. Third game against Miracle on the play, finally. Another pretty rough hand. I think the synergy between Entomb, Bakarian Feeder, and Baldegast is pretty good, because Entomb just puts a bridge in the graveyard. And then I have the Bloodlust Cairn Feeder synergy, but this synergy just gets stopped by a plow. I think I keep. And I'm going to start a turn by playing a Cairn Feeder. Not gonna have six this time around though. Based on what I draw, by the way, I should have just played Badlands. 1 week of not playing Hogaak, and I just totally forgot that you need to play Blood Crypt or Badland on turn one. Alright. I think I'm just gonna curve out Cairn Feeder Bloodgast. Alright, Island. Doesn't mean the plow, at least. And it's not a Cairn Feeder, okay. Attack. And fetch again. No, not fetch again. Just play a regular land this time. Because I could use all the fetch lands with the Cairn Feeders and Bloodgast. To play around Surgical too. See, a very fair start. But I can do something pretty cool with the Entomb. Getting a bridge in the graveyard. Alright, I passed the turn, and I'm not necessarily inclined into just going big here. Why, what do I draw? Hogaak. Ooh, now we're talking. Now we're talking. Alright. So. Alright, let's do this. Let's attack with Bloodgast. And then let's play Entomb for Bridge. Probably just play Land as well. Again, it's pretty awkward to play Land with Bloodgast in actual Graveyard. But I want to play around Spell Pierce. So I'm going to go Entomb. Then I can tap 3, 4, speech counterbalance. Okay. We want to play Cairn Feeder. Do we want to play Cairn Feeder? Yeah, I think I do. If they go Brainstorm Terminus, so be it. That will all lay in the graveyard. Alright, fetch first. Planes. Ah, bad news, Mengu. Bad news, bad news. Seems like it's the Terminus in hand. Next turn, I'll depend. Maybe if I'd kept this in hand, I could have been able to play Hogaak. Because he had 4-5 and then just cast. Play this from hand, play this Bloodgast, play Hogaak. Yeah, playing two Cairn Feeder together means it's weird, but what if they have a plow? Okay, then they need the second Cairn Feeder. It's just playing around, like, Brainstorm Terminus or plow? I think it's better to play around the Brainstorm, plow than play around Brainstorm Terminus. Alright, so they're dipping the tank here. Really hope they didn't find a Terminus in the top, I don't know, 12 cards of their deck. I guess it's just... Oh, yeah, top 15 cards, should find one. Alright, don't find it, no, no, stop in draw step. Alright. Sacrifice all this thing. Actually, let them cast it, let them pay one white. Okay, now, I sacrifice all these things. Yes. Alright. All down. Fetch end of turn, get a... whatever, Badland. Okay, that comes back. Out of land. Yeah, they had Karen Feeder, could have gone Karen Feeder, or Hogaak, it would have been great, but of course. As I said, I did play around stuff. So yeah. Things are looking very bad right now. Predict. Ooh, even predict. They know the top because they discarded a brainstorm. So this is just a 2 mana draw two cards, which is kind of out. Yeah, I don't know. You just don't see it very often these days, but maybe with Ren 6 now, the Planeswalkers will see less and less play. The Narset and the Fair will see less and less play. Or the middle of Prismatic Vista. Mm-hmm. Them taking Volcanic there kind of means to me that they don't have back to basics anymore. Not sure how much it matters because I think we're kind of dead. I don't know. If I draw a black creature, at least I can play this Hogaak. Big regrets on debt. Karen Fiedler number two being played, but that was basically the only channel. The other decisions that we had in this game. An opponent, as every good Miracle player, is taking their sweet time to make any decision, but that's just the nature of a Miracle player in Legacy. They're usually not very fast at making decisions, even though they always make the best ones. And yeah, the deck is one of the best deck indeed. And we draw another land. All right, another land will seal the deal. All right, good game, and the Domain wins the match. We'll be back for round number three. But before that, remember, this is ChannelFireball.com. You can buy this card that you are missing via ChannelFireball.com, but you can also sell the cards that you are not using anymore to ChannelFireball at ChannelFireball.com/buylist. You can check their pricing your cards, and then add a 30% store credit bonus if you want to trade. Match number three on the play, finally. And we got a super land heavy hand. I don't understand what's happening these days with these hands. All right, let's scratch the bottom one of these. Let's get a bad land and this Placeseizure Supplier. Usually I was looking for a Vengevine in Modern in game ones, but now, wow, this is a great hit. Dwarfcrawler and Bridge from Below. This could enable the turn to Hogaak. No, it doesn't. Yes, it does. No, it doesn't, sorry. I was just thinking about all the options. And yeah, I don't find one that makes me play Hogaak on turn two, because if I play Rivercrawl, there's only three cards in the bin, and the fetch line is just a fourth. So I think my better chance here is just to cast an Altar of Dementia and just attack for one. I'll get a swamp. Hoping that no spell pierce me. Alright, so maybe another miracle deck. Sure. Attack and pass. Alright, rematch against miracles. 2 mana, what's this? 2 mana? Stoneforge Mystic, okay, no miracles. I need to draw Carrion Feeder to make Hogaak good. Otherwise, white deck, just plow it. And it's not good. Alright, I got a Battle School, sure. Cabal Therapy. Alright, let's Cabal Therapy our opponent, naming Battle School. See what they have. Sure. Now I can play Gravecrawler. Cabal Therapy my opponent with a Gravecrawler. Or maybe play. Maybe actually play Hogaak first. And then mill the Stitcher Supplier. No, I'd rather just use the Gravecrawler. And then source the Plowshares. Swords. Shares. So which card do I see? It is 4, right? Yes, okay. Now I can just fetch, I think. So that I exile is 5 cards. Yes, perfect. So we fetch. Get another Bedland. Play the Gravecrawler. Then I'll play Hogaak. And I think I can tap this zombie. Alright, I could have sacrificed Teacher Supplier, but I don't know. I don't think a 1-1 is that stupid here. Ponder shuffles, okay. And Luminary Island, Stoneforge Mystic. Mm-hmm. To get it was out shit. That's fine. Now I draw another Hogaak. So if I attack with all here, I think it's good. Yeah, they're gonna eat my bridge most likely just by blocking like this, but they take a bunch of damage and then the Hogaak should probably just stomp them. Alright, I set to block like this, which will mill me 3 cards. Wow, only like this? Interesting. So I get a zombie and they mill all 3 cards? Maybe they don't know exactly what the bridge does. Alright, I milled a Gravecrawler. And I'll pass the turn. Yeah, I'm gonna keep this swamp in my hand just in case I somehow mill some Bloodghasts. I could have played Hogaak, but and just make a zombie with a bridge, but it would have exiled the bridge, so there was no zombie to make. Alright, I go Ponder looking for a plow on my Hogaak. They maybe find it because they don't shuffle. They could also find us as a Snapcast Ranger too. Alright, so they also have a counterspell for my Hogaak here. Mm-hmm. Or do I want to attack with all? If I attack with all, they're on 6, right? If I attack with all, they go like block, block. The bridge dies, but I got 2 zombies. Yeah, I think it's... And then they can play Hogaak as well. Alright, attack with all. If they chump block the zombies, that's also fine. I'm not going to play Hogaak, but it means that they don't have creatures to keep the jit. And if the block only one, they die because they're in 6. So I need to block 2. Alright, I concede. Good game. Good and fair game. Alright. Maybe I like shenanigans here. I'm still not gonna play around Rest in Peace. Maybe I just have a 1 shenanigans for one land. I think that this deck really has too many lands against the Dawn Wasteland deck. So yeah, I'm gonna go like this. This time I'm not gonna bring in Coffin Purge for the Surgical. Let's go with this. Alright, finally just 1 land. I love it. I love being mind screwed with this deck. Land go, it's what they do. Alright, I'm gonna just start off with a Faithless Loading. If they counter it, so be it. Yeah, I could also go a couple of Therapy, but I'd rather just wait until turn 2. Maybe to play a plot, maybe to play. Alright, so this got a bridge and a. Maybe 2 bridges. Yeah, I'm gonna go to a bridge. If they surgical them, you know, it's not the end of the word. I can start casting these Gravecrawler from hand. Whereas if they surgical either bridge or Gravecrawler, they would get card advantage because they have the other piece in my hand. I stick a brainstorm shuffle and ponder, I guess, yeah. Alright, so next turn, I can go Cabal Therapy. Naming. Oh, Torment's correct, okay. I can go Cabal Therapy. Maybe I can go Gravecrawler first, then Cabal Therapy. Because if that resolves, I can flashback the Cabal Therapy. And then I can destroy everything, though. So maybe the best is just to play a land, play 2 Gravecrawler, pass the turn. I can't go into him for a guy I can play it immediately. Because I don't have 2 black sources. So yeah, had I discarded a bridge and the Gravecrawler, I could have net card advantage by playing the Gravecrawler from the band. I'll put in Surgical, so... Sorry, Torment's Crypt. Alright, that's a True Name Nemesis. Not a big deal though. Oh, that's a bridge. So, what I can do here is Cabal Therapy myself, and then Cabal Therapy my opponent. Then I think I can Entomb and put a... Yeah, I think I'm a guy into play. Should be able to cast everything. Alright, maybe I should start just... Yeah, I'm gonna go color therapy myself. Yeah, I'm gonna go color therapy myself. Then bridge from below and then entomb. Bridge from below. Then I can't color therapy them. Naming probably just force of will. Yeah, then force of will. So now I got a zombie. Force of will. Force of will. And they don't have it. Ooh, they have a lot of ways to kill a Hogaak though. So maybe we should change plan here. So I'm definitely putting to play this grave crawler. Oh wait, maybe I should entomb for a Cabal therapy. I actually was not able to cast the thing regardless. The Hogaak. So maybe now I should just go for another Cabal therapy. Naming source to plowshares. Because I think with Hogaak is that it doesn't do much here. Cabal therapy, it's so-so. But maybe it's not that bad. Just taking control. I mean, they will exile both of these, so at least. Yeah, I think I'm exiling the... I mean, yeah, just I'm going to do play, I think. I like it. Yes. I'll name... I think I'll say Judgment. Actually, source of pressure. And I'll pass. Not sure if this was like good or bad. It's probably not great. I mean, I did put some things into play and the bridge in the graveyard, which is cool, but I don't know. Could do better indeed. Alright, I'm going to attack with if I attack with everything, it's not great. I'm just gonna attack with this. Opponent will obviously not block it. Or it will. Doesn't seem very good to block this, honestly. Alright. Mm-hmm, so that's the land. So now they can go Constant Judgment to one of these. Sure. And the Steel of Counterspell up. So where Crawl's gone, I'll attack with it. Bloodgast, interesting. That's okay, I'll attack with Gravecrawler. Gonna leave this land in my hand so the next turn I can attack with a Bloodgast and the Gravecrawler. Alright, it's time to take it. Smart. Smart opponent. Alright, the fact that they tapped no, it's okay. Alright, it's not a land. Good. So now I start attacking. I can even attack with all now. Because I'll take 8 down to 9 and... Or maybe just attack with these two. Yeah. Maybe just attack with these two. Anyone that can block can just reanimate for free. And also get a zombie in the meanwhile. I'm not gonna play a land here. Again, Faithless Looting is a thing. Maybe I should play a fetch land, I don't know. Alright, if they drew something good. It's a Truant Nemesis. Is it good though? I mean, it's not bad, but funnily enough, it's not like the best that they could have done. Despite we are in a race, and you might think that Truant Nemesis is just the best card in any race. But the fact that it doesn't die makes so that the bridge is just a beating. Why'd I take it again? Alright, there are 9 here. There. It's not a joke. This is not a joke. I'm gonna play a land this time. Alright, they drew a cantrip, looks like. A ponder, okay, let's see what they do. They're looking for I don't know, even a sweeper doesn't do, I mean, a sweeper does, yeah, a sweeper doesn't do anything. It's fine, it's not that bad. No, it's actually super bad now. A sweeper doesn't do anything. Alright, they don't shuffle. Wow, what is it? Jace. I can't really see Jace doing much because they block two. They're gonna actually they die here, so they need to find a plow. If they don't find. Wow, they got planes? The island? Okay, they have planes. So they maybe have a counter spell and maybe they shuffle, I don't know. And they brainstorm, and I'm gonna expect a concession here after this brainstorm. I don't really see too many things going their way here. They have two blockers that take exactly eight in tomb that could get another bridge if I want to. So yeah, I could have also got a Bloodgast. That maybe would have been the best play, but they have a counterspell. Let's just not make them use counterspell. Alright, so they go block, they need to go plow. Alright, I block those, and yeah, they do the plow, they go to one. Sure, and what's this? Two ply? So I still purge? So I still purge. So what can entomb do here? Not much. I could entomb for a Cabal Therapy. It's not even guaranteed that they have a counterspell in their hand. It is somewhat guaranteed though. I mean, what am I putting in my graveyard? I mean, I kept putting a graveyard, like I had a grave crawler or a Bloodgast. It's not much. I mean, a Faithless Loading is not that bad. I think a Cabal Therapy actually makes the most sense. It's also a 2/2 body. And yeah, just if they discard Counterstone, means that they get put one card back less from their hand. Snapcaster Mage. Okay. Alright. I could see myself losing the game now. Had I put into play just a Bloodgast pre-combat, I would have won this game. If I had just gone Bloodgast. Ooh, the Dritchit. Oh no. Oh no, I lose now. Had I gone for Entomb for. Yeah, I mean, even if they counterspell dead, they die. So yeah, that was just stupid. I should have gone for Bloodgast. Whoa. Alright. What do we want to draw here? Do I have any dark damage? I don't want to. But I have Shining Gas in my deck. Tormod's Crypt. Another land. Oh no, I'm losing this game. That's insane. Yeah, I'm losing this game. Because not Plow and... I mean, my only hope is that they don't, that they think that this charges first, but I don't think they are, they think that they know the rules, so they will go snap plow, that they block my old board, and they win. Could game some damage, should have won this game. Rider. I mean, just entomb for Bloodgast last turn, and then go for there. I did not expect them to come back, honestly. I was just playing my cards randomly, the classic magic player when you're ahead. Alright, I still like Shenanigans for the surgical, for the Tormod's Crypt, and I don't like anything else, so let's just submit this. Alright, game number 3. Okay, keep this hand. It does have some of the key cards, Altar and Hogaak. We are going to looting away, I don't know, hopefully some good graveyard matter cards, and not just lands. We are drawing many, many lands, but that's okay. Alright, we did draw two total garbage cards. And I'm gonna get rid of probably just an Hogaak, yeah. I mean, if they are surgical, it's so good. Sorry, Tormod's Crypt or whatever you wanna do. Cabal Therapy. I'm gonna play Altar of Dementia. Hopefully the spell appears. Or Force of Negation, or Brainstorm. Then, next turn I could just flashback the looting, honestly. If they play Stoneforge Mystic, then maybe I go Cabal Therapy. Or they go Force of Will. Pitching Brainstorm. Alright. Delta pass. Okay. Yeah, I'll play Fitless Looting from the graveyard. Drawing two more lands. We're not being very lucky with this deck, I have to admit. We did throw away game two, so we kind of deserve to be unlucky, but... Yep. Alright, so they fetch, because they knew the top card of Brainstorm. It's another land, it's going to be a Patron of Nemesis, probably. Oh, Torment's Gravity. There's literally nothing in my graveyard, so... I keep on drawing lands. Okay, so I'm going to Cabal Therapy my opponent. Naming, Jason Sculptor. Okay. I'm gonna ponder then. They're trying to hide. Oh no, they don't. Alright, I'm gonna name Jason Sculptor. Okay. I could entomb for Bloodghast. It's not bad. I'm gonna do it. They do have Brainstorm, but they have another Cabal Therapy. So I'm gonna do that. Attempt to return Bloodghast. If they sacrifice the crypt, I can fetch again and get my Bloodghast back. That would eat. Whoa, I don't have left land. I don't have lands left anymore. Oh, that's very unfortunate. They boarded at one. So yeah, the Tormos crypt is gone, and I'll pass the turn now. Let them play the Brainstorm. Actually, yeah, then they're gonna cancel judgment my creature. So maybe. Maybe I should just Cabal Therapy them and just save this in the graveyard. It's not really coming back because nah, it's okay. Let them constantly check. Wow, they forgot to break Brainstorm from the graveyard. Okay, so the constant judgment will turn analysis from the top. All right, that is okay. I can still, I don't know if I draw. Well, I could get back from this. That's a good start. Alright, so let's discard our whole land first. Gonna go Cabal Therapy, discarding Council Judgment. Council's Judgment. And, Battle Skull. Then, I'll... Do I play a land? Yeah, why not? I'll play a land and pass the turn. I'm 16, so now they attack me for 11. Down to 11. I'll plow from the top. Okay. And, alright, now... Now, it's going to be very hard now. It's going to be very hard now. Oh no, something else? Okay, I'm gonna concede this game. Alright, sure. We lost this match. Very close. Should have won game two. This game is not necessarily gone my way, but that's okay. Let's go to round number four. Round number four. Karen Feeder, Bloodghast, Bridge, Hogaak. It's not particularly good, but I'm gonna keep it. Maybe I should be more aggressive with these mulligans. I don't know, without Neonate, I kind of feel like this deck has less ways to discard. Like in Modern, I was modding a little bit more, I think, but there was Neonate. Right now, there's no Neonate, so I kind of feel like it's weird to mulligan four enablers when you only have eight enablers. I don't consider Entomb or a Cabal Therapy enabler. So, let me keep this hand. Alright, looks like another one of those blue-white deck. I don't know what's up. Running 6 is legal, guys. I can assure you that. You are allowed to play other colors as well. Alright, what's the draw? Hopefully, Fiddler's Loading, I guess. Fiddler's gonna be an incredible draw here, discarding these two. If I don't draw any of these, it's gonna go Swamp Clearing Fear. Because that could still be playing Wasteland and risking it. Risking the bad line, I don't think I wanna. I want exposed to that. And the only upside is, again, if we draw Fateless Looting, that is the only upside to go Badland. Well, Fetchland Badland. Bottom is their Scry and Polluted Delta for more cantrips, I assume. Bulk. Chainline. Nope. Alright. Draw step is another Hogaak. I'm gonna go for Bloodgust here with another Swamp. Quentin definitely plays Wasteland, and I don't want to get hurt. So, 2 mana Bloodgust. And then next turn I can go Carrion Feeder, attack first, then Carrion Feeder, sacrifice the Bloodgust to the Carrion Feeder, land, and just pass the turn, because I don't want to get Wastelanded once again, as I said. So just why would it be a great draw? Fateless Loading would be a good draw. Alright, they brainstorm and pass, okay. We draw one more land. If you're okay. We're drawing a lot of these, but that's fine. So I'm gonna go for Carrion Feeder. Sacrifice it to the Ghast. Fetch land go. Force speech preordain. Okay. Flip with Preordain, it was obvious that we would have flipped because they played Brainstorm. Preordain goes bottom, okay, interesting. And let's start the clock here. We are looking for any black creature cast my Hogaak here. Because they have 5, but with these 2 fetch lands. I'm not gonna fetch end of turn because I could draw Altar or Scaring Feeder to use the fetch land. Alright, one more land. Exactly what they did not want. Probably any spell would have been good here. And I'll pass. They might have a force token from Hogaak, which doesn't do too much because you can cast it again for the graveyard, but since we don't have any single thing, I'm still not gonna fetch end of turn, because if I draw Altar, any of this fetch land represent two cards. So I prefer like this. Alright, they don't shuffle with a Ponder to play a Delver. The clock here is ticking. I need to draw something good. Draw Gravecrawler, which is like whatever, but it's fine. Fetch these and play Hogaak. Yeah, I can't get more swamps. Now I pass. Alright, they force speech dates. Okay. Keep playing in my hand, because if I draw Altar, I need it. Alright, I have 2 turn clock, because the Diver definitely flips, because they play Pond on last turn. They don't flip, okay. They maybe really needed that Force of Will. Arcanist. Alright, let's draw Altar and win, please. Let's draw Altar and win, please. Altar. Carrion Feeder. Just attack. I should be dead on board, though. I mean, that one might not flip. Alright, so I'm not dead on board. They go to 10 here. My Carrion Feeder gets very large. Actually, I have that on board because the chain lightning is a. So this is 4, 5, 8. So yeah, I'm dead on board. Because none of my zombies can block. I'm still gonna make them have it, I think. It takes a while. What I'm doing is probably just irrelevant. But if they don't go for it, it is relevant that I am doing my best. Alright, now I pass. Alright, this one should not flip because it didn't flip last turn. But if they attack with all, then they just give flashback to chain line. I just saw a line. That would have made me alive. If I don't tap these badlands and they just pass, they go chain lightning. I guess they can chain lightning me back. But I would have bowled this, so I would have taken 6 damage from steel lightning, 7. So yeah, I would have still died. Because that could just chain lightning on in the chains. But yeah, I mean, as I said, it's I played on Sunday and people, legacy players just don't know that these cards can't block. I mean, I'm not saying that my opponent is bad or anything. I'm just saying that it's something new, so it's fine to just not know that. Alright, so the question is now, do I want to sacrifice? No, I don't think so. Again, if I draw Altar, it's 2 more cards. Come on, Altar. Into hoop. A friend of mine said that you play Gamble instead of Entomb. That might be super right about it, honestly. So, what is Entomb gonna do? Nothing, I think. I mean, Faithless Loading, maybe. Nah, but I would need to draw exactly a land Altar. I mean, it's something. What if I Entomb a Bloodgast? And attack with all, they just go block, block, and it's super dead. So I'm super dead. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna go for Faithless Looting, and I hope to top deck exactly those 2 cards. I think I can easily win if I draw the Altar. I don't think they have anything here. Stop yours. Okay, I'm still not gonna concede. Opponent looks like they don't. We know that my creature can't block, so. I mean, now I'm definitely not on board. It's just attack and fly. Alright, concede game. Okay, I don't think I want to sideboard anything in this matchup. Thalia does not do much. Oh, yeah, I'm just gonna roll this back. If they have Surgical, it's fine. I'm not really. You know, there's not much I can do about Surgical. I'm not a fan of sideboarding and Thoughtseize against a deck that burns me. So I'm just gonna submit this. Alright. We got a good hand. Discarding now. Bloodgast for sure. Probably Hogaak. I don't know if I put in place Tormod Crypt or Surgical Extraction. In any case, I really want to get rid of just to grab your matter cards and not, you know, other cards. Alright. Those are the 2 best cards to discard with Faithless Loading. Next turn I can cast Hogaak. Finally, turn to Hogaak. Because round 4 and I still didn't do it. I guess I should have mulliganed more some other times. I could regret that some keeps that I made along the game. I maybe just put too much value on the Entomb. Alright, Ponder does not shuffle. Let's play Stitcher Supplier. And Stitcher Supplier, right, I'm thinking about it. Do you have Surgical? They might. Alright, let's play Stitcher Supplier actually. Let's play like this. Let's play Carrion Feeder first and then Stitcher Supplier. This way, no, actually, yeah, if I just mill an Hogaak, whatever, it's on me. Wow, yeah, this is the reason. If I get a Bloodgast, it's much better. Well, I would have loved to just get a fetch land, so it would have been even better. All right, now Carrion Feeder. It's pretty great. Let's see if they dates this. They don't dates this. All right, let's have the teacher supplier to the Carrion Feeder. All right, I got lucky that there's no Hogaak, but I don't know if they have. I don't think they have. I don't think they have it at this point. Shuffle my card and play in Hogaak. Even if they date this, it's fine. Could have tapped two less and exile two more, but I wouldn't have been able to replay Hogaak, so I'm actually very much happy with how this game went. I mean, we have 10 powers and they have zero permanents. I'm gonna win this game rather easily. Yeah, I mean, I did draw very well this game, so even Surgical Extraction on Bloodgust would have been okay, not even great, because I can still go Carrion Feeder or Hogaak. And you know, just keep on going. Alright, I'll sacrifice a bunch of things in response to the Tormod Crypt. I could have actually done this and played Hogaak. I don't know why I actually didn't see this play, sorry guys. I was very much into it, just I win, doesn't matter. I should have done this play and just replayed Hogaak from the graveyard. But it's okay, I mean, it's just a quattro. Oh, dude, it's just 16 power, yeah. Nothing I can do about this. Alright, so once again, I'm playing as Tormod's Crypt, and I don't think I'm a Shenanigans or anything else, so I just submit this deck. Alright, we got another very good hand. Opponent is keeping 7, but they have a. No, they might have the 6, okay. Delver. Let's go Swamp Supplier. Dates would be annoying because Supplier is one of the key cards, but you know, this is Legacy, so you have interaction. It's okay, I mean, you don't expect them to not have anything. Alright, flip the Delver immediately, that's rough. Ponder from the top. They do not shuffle. Hopefully they don't even have a Surgical or a Tormod's Crypt. Alright. Oof. I'm gonna play land first. Another days would be pretty bad. I really wanna play Hogaak this turn. And I think I'm gonna go for a Gravecrawler. With a swamp or a badland. Do they have a wasteland? They might have a wasteland. I'm gonna go Gravecrawler because they're less likely to date this. And even if the date's the Hogaak, it's not that bad. I don't care about eating the Faithless Looting. Alright. So this is the Hogaak, but next turn we can go Carrion Feeder, eat this, and then rebuild. And I can even start with the Entomb for a bridge first. Badland. I don't know what to do. Let's think. Alright, so if I go in Tomb, there's a. Yeah, I think it's better. So I'm gonna go land in Tomb, clear on Spell Pierce, or end plus Storm. So I got a bridge. Actually, I should have played Carrion Feeder first. This way they can bolt the, you know, I don't know. And they can force it through my feeder, I guess. Actually, it's not that bad, because they have altar afterwards. So let's play Carrion Feeder first. So if they have force of will on this. Brainstorm, okay. So they have force of will on this. Come on, resolve. Oh, force of will. All right. So attack and pass. Next to the altar could be the ways to go off, actually go off, just actually win the game. The two cards in it, please don't find this Tormod's Crypt. If you find a Tormod's Crypt, it's pretty bad. Alright, the one card in it, hopefully it's not, what can it be? Just Surgical Attraction, it's the only thing that they can have. Why did they play Tormod's Crypt with this in their deck? Alright, regardless, let's attempt to win here. I'm gonna go through with the Mancium. And now I think I should be able to win the game. Mill this. Wow, look at how many bridge we got. Yeah, so let's play Hogaak. And it's now over. Three bridge, wow. It's gonna be the game 100%. Oof. This was close. Put in dead a lot of interaction. We still managed to get there. That's what happens when you get a good hand. I mean, maybe it was supposed to mulligan more in the previous rounds. I was just complaining that they got unlucky. Maybe it was just my hand that sucked. Alright, opponent doesn't want to concede. Maybe they want to see how this game actually wins. What is the powerful combination that everyone is talking about? Alright. Right, as I said, old priority and cast this. It doesn't matter, it's just an habit. It's just better if you do it all the time. So that when it actually matters, you don't forget about that. Start milling them. I have 8 cards in my deck. Not that it matters. I mean, I can even go to 0 cards in my deck, but I have more than enough to just win, to just kill my opponent here. Alright. Yeah, I didn't click it through. Alright, so control, click on this, click on this. Hold priority, mail. Alright, and this is going to be the game, because you have more than 40 cards to mail them, and then we just pass the turn. All right, good game, and we are back for round number 5. Hopefully, we will just open good hands. Okay, sure. We have one enabler and 2 half enablers. Still need to reconsider the needs for this deck to keep the 7, because I keep some loose 7, I think, in this video. When I started practicing for Modern with this deck, it was one of the big thing that was messing up at the early stages of that testing. All right, so let's go. Point is on 6, Ancient Dance, so they must play the deck, the Bomberman deck, which has a 3 Tormoise Grip in the graveyard as an interaction. That's as much as they have. Okay, let's start with the Stitcher Supplier. Unless I get comboed off, I think it should be a pretty... Actually, no, it's not true. It's not an easy game at all, because they have a Chalice of the Void. So what is the best place to do things to do against Chalice of the Void? I don't know, just mill some Bloodghast with the Stitcher Supplier. Or just type, oh no, Chalice, because this then doesn't really be Chalice. Arg. Alright, it's a very awful card, so if opponent doesn't play Chalice here, we're gonna go turn to Hogaak. If opponent does play Chalice, I'm gonna lose. Oh, that's a Citadel. Alright, wow, they passed. Okay, I'm so happy right now. Oof. Okay, so let's go for Care and Feeder. Fetch land. Yeah, swamp. Play Entomb. And play Hogaak. This is why you play Hogaak, and you're playing Entomb over Gamble, maybe. I mean, it's probably the same because you just discard a random card and you can cast Aga from the hand. It's probably even better because it could have discarded a Blood Gust or a Bridge or a Grave Crawler. So yeah, all this would have been probably better. Our opponent, what are they doing? Playing Legacy opponent, not Pauper. I mean, I could just die next turn if they go Bomberman. Yeah. All right, let's sacrifice this. It's the same amount of damage, but I could hit. I hear there's no Vengevine. I don't know what I could hit. A Cabal Therapy, I guess, to discard Bomberman. That's the only thing I can think of. Right, that's a Cabal Therapy. That's good. Let's play Grave Crawler. I'll ask Cabal Therapy my opponent. I'll name Oryx Vagers. Sorry, I can also. No, it's okay. Alright, Oryx Avengers. I thought about if I could kill them. I probably should have counted. Maybe I could have actually killed them. Okay. Alright, so that's the deck we're playing against. It's gonna dispatch my Hogaak. Too bad that Care and Feeder will save it, and they will safely bring it back to from the death. Then fetch land, yes. Alright, I don't know. If opponent has some weird combo, but I don't think so. I think there's just the budget deck. Alright, so let's play our card. And let's attack. There was a way where if they didn't have anything, we could have gone Cabal Therapy myself and the Riskar Bridge, and then maybe we could have just killed them with the Hogaak plus the Carrion Feeder. But it turns out that there's just a fair deck. Alright, I'm gonna go Shenanigans and do I just wanna die if they have a rest in peace? They don't have rest in peace, come on. Just separate one of the classic land and submit this deck. Alright, we do have Altered Dementia as an enabler. I think that'll be enough to keep. Maybe I should have boarded in wear tear. I don't know, I think my opponent just playing the. I really don't know. Budget. No, I call it budget. I think it's just some super beginner deck. Alright. Let's play Stitcher Supplier. And. We have three cards. Nothing basically. Faithless Looting in this deck, it doesn't really have a flashback. Like, if it was Careful Study, like, a Careful Study would have been red, and I don't think. I mean, obviously, you would love for Careful Study to have flashback, but yeah, I mean, it's just an upside, but. Okay, what did they do? Lightning Braves. I remember liking this card a lot when I was a kid. Alright, I don't even know what to. Alright, let's do this. I'm gonna go Altered Dementia and then pass the turn. Just make sure they don't. Maybe I should have just Cabal Therapy Damage because they have some random cards that interacts with me. Like some Graveyard Matter card. Like some 3 drop that does something bad. that they own, that they put in their cyber for graveyard decks. It's very likely that if I just get on top this turn and win, because I mill at least 4, 8, 10 cards. I'm gonna just cast Bloodghast. I think that's a 6 as well as the Grave Crawlers. But yeah, I think I'd rather just go for the 1 mana Grave Crawler. Because I could change my mind along the way if I hit something else. Best draw would probably be, I mean, Hogaak or Entomb. Basically, having 8 Hogaak, I think it's great. Maybe Gamble is better, I don't know. Also, let's see. If they do something between Erupt and me or I just cast something. Like a Master of Ethereum. And I keep it. And I shouldn't have attacked. But it's okay. Alright. Entomb. Alright, let's go Gravecrawler. Let's go. I think I don't want to kill about Therapy Dam. I'm not going to play around anything. I don't think they have much to disrupt me. Or maybe they do. The thing is that if they don't find what I want, I could just break here. It's possible that I can break. It's not zero the chances of me breaking if I just eat a land to cast Cabal Therapy. Whereas if I don't cast Cabal Therapy, I have two more mills. So I think that's actually what I need to do here. So let's start by Altar of Dementia at a Grave Crawler. Bridge. Alright. Now I think I can cast the Cabal Therapy. So I'm casting this first, just to make sure. Actually, no, I can't. I should have not cast this, but it's okay. So now I have to go for Entomb. I'm just not going to play around anything. I don't think my opponent has a deck that interacts with me. I'm just going Entomb. Put in Hogaak in the graveyard. Cast it. Let's mill myself for 8 to make a token. Let's replay Hogaak and now we go off. Alright, so with Altar, as I said, you should have a pretty clear turn 3 win every time. This deck is Legacy, we have Entomb, so we do find a lot of Hogaak. So once you open an Altar, it's almost a lock to just be able to find what you want. I think I'm gonna go for Cabal Therapy now. I don't know. I just want to see what's in their hand. I just want to see. And this is not like, yeah, whatever. Obviously, it's impossible to have Surgical, but I can't think of anything else. Yeah. Okay. And this will be it, and this is gonna be it. Thanks, I guess, thanks for watching. I'm gonna start to say thanks first, because the game is over. And the changes that I could make, maybe, are to cut two and two and try Gamble. The fact that you can take Altar, it's a pretty big deal, I think. The fact that you can take Altar is a pretty big deal, so I would honestly just switch two and two. land, maybe even 19. I don't know. When they're playing against a Wasteland deck, those are decks that all right, is the opponent on top of everything just now left the table? All right, good, you're gonna. I believe that's what's happening. I think that just normal people don't understand how rude it is. Just leave the table when you lose, but it's okay. All right, as conceded, that's all good. All right, we won a chest and 100 point. I regret the loss against the blue-white Stoneblade, and maybe I regret the keep game 3 against the Miracle. So, obviously, this is basically a 2-2 because the last round didn't really matter. And thanks for watching, guys. I'll be back. I don't know, next time with more Hogaak. I have another Hogaak deck to try. Today's Hogaak day. I'm recording two videos today because I'm leaving for Barcelona. I've got a MC Barcelona Modern. I'm gonna leave a bunch of legacy videos for you. And yep, see you next time. If you like this video, please press like on YouTube channel, and I'll see you tomorrow. Sorry, tomorrow. Next time.